Yes, yes, I was about to get to that. James is doing very good.
Hey, James,
I need all the help I can get. Our speaker this morning is Reverend Valerie Mansfield. Our theme is The Summer of Love from the 1960s. Her talk will be titled Such a Strange Vibration. I'm looking forward to that because I remember 1968. Reverend Gwen Moser will be doing our meditation. William Driscol, who's also a board member, will be doing the Daily Word. The fabulous sisters Essenpree, Janet and Lisa will be providing our special music. Judy, as always, is on the piano. Thank you. Gloria is our song leader, and as always, we have Deb and our good friend Phil will be joining in a lot of the music. Okay. And it's always well coordinated with the talk, as I'm certain it will be today. All you need is love?
All you need is love.
Let's do it.
Please stand and join us for All You Need Is Love.
Thank you.
Love, love, love. Love, love, love. Love, love, love. It's easy.
Love, nothing you can do that can be done. Nothing you can sing that can be sung. Nothing you can say, but you can learn how to play the game. It's easy.
Love, nothing you can make love, that can't be made. No love, one you can save love, that can't be saved. Love, nothing you can do, love, but you can learn love, to be you in time. It's easy.
All you need is love. All you need is love. All you need is love.
Love. Love is all you need. There's nothing you can know that is known. Nothing you can see that isn't shown. No way you can go that isn't where you're meant to be. It's easy.
All you need is love. All you need is love. All you need is love.
Love. Love is all you need.
Thank you very much. But for the fact that Val has worked all week on doing a tremendous talk this morning, we could just go home after that song. Okay, so everybody is seated. One of our traditions here at Unity of Louisville is to greet our first-time guests. We are a loving, prosperous community, and we welcome everyone who chooses to join us here on Sunday. So if you've chosen to be with us today for the first time, if you would, raise your hand as I am raising mine, so our ushers can give you a gift. Behind you, Donna. There's another. We promise not to stalk you, but if you would come downstairs, there's a sheet of paper on the package you're giving. Fill it out, and we'll give you a little remembering gift. And there's also a candle that's coming to you to remind you that of the Christ spirit that lives inside of you. One of the most important things that Reverend Ray says that I might be able to get out without tripping over my tongue is that wherever you are and whoever you are on your spiritual journey, you are welcome here. Please, let's greet our first-time guests. And for our two first-time guests, the senior minister is much smoother than I am, so come back and see how this is done correctly. Okay. After that, we've got to greet our neighbors. We know each other. We love each other. We're all glad to be here, so please stand and greet your friends. Hug only if they seem like they're prepared to be hugged. Shake a hand if not, but most people here will hug, so just get used to it. James, time for the affirmation. Thank you. Thank you. I appreciate you putting it up there. We affirm all sorts of things throughout the years. This month, we're affirming that we are on a spiritual journey. If you will join with me in reading the words under spiritual journey, we are on an ever-evolving spiritual path. We claim our oneness. Thank you very much. And again, other than Val and the fabulous Essenpre sisters who haven't performed yet, we could go home after that. Okay. Next, we'll be singing the Lord's Prayer, to be followed by a moment of silence during which our oneness blessers will bless the congregation. So if you would please join in singing and then join in silence.
Forgive our debt. And so it is. The Daily Word for today, Sunday, September 16th, 2018, is world peace. Peace in my life is my contribution to peace in the world. Reading or watching the news today may cause me to feel frustrated and angry. It would seem that there is little I can do to affect events in the world. Surely world peace lies well beyond my abilities. Yet I know and affirm that all life is an expression of spiritual consciousness. My every thought plays a vital role in determining not only how my life will unfold, but what I am contributing to the collective consciousness. The peace I choose to express in my life resonates into all of creation. As today unfolds, I welcome every opportunity to stop and center myself. Through my spiritual willingness, I contribute to peace in the world. From John 16:33, I have said this to you so that in me you may have peace. In the world you face persecution, but take courage. I have conquered the world. Today's daily word is world peace, and the affirmation is, peace in my life is my contribution to peace in the world.
As we prepare to enter a time of meditation, hold that thought of the song just sung. In this room, nothing but love. As you hold that thought, let the natural flow of your breathing take you to a deeper place. With each breath, allow distracting thoughts to move away. Each breath in, breathe in spirit. The love of this room, breathe it into you. With each breath, God is. I am. God is. I am. As you go deeper into the silence, let your thoughts go simply to love, a love that enfolds you, always enfolding you. And from that enfolding love, begin to feel calm, feel a peace that comes from Spirit's love for you. And in that love, begin to experience the oneness that you have with Spirit. Breathe in, breathe out. God is. I am. And enter into the silence, knowing you are one with Spirit. Begin to come back to this time and this place. Open your eyes. Stretch a little bit. As we come back to this physical world, be aware of God's love. And the time you have spent in oneness. And be aware that from this experience, we have a new song to sing. all we need is love. All we need is love for ourselves and for others. And as we leave this place today, may that love shine from you to others. Perhaps as simple as a smile, simple as a recognition of others. All we need is love. So it is. Namaste.
So we're coming to San Francisco with some flowers in our hair. And we continue our series of the metaphysics of the summers of love to highlight our beautiful musicians. Thank you all very much. Thank you, Phil, for coming up with this. As you can tell from my attire today, you know, kind of young to be the hippie, but definitely was the flower child, and still am. I left the hippies up to my brother, my older brother and sister. They were in that time of the revolution and the change, and moving from the outer to the inner. And in all that chaos and confusion. So in unity, what we would say is that we move from that atom sense of consciousness. So in the Bible, in the Old Testament, Adam represents those senses, our five senses that we have, right? And then the Christ represents that divinity that is alive within us and moving outward. And so during the 60s, we were moving, really started moving from that sense, sight, hear, hearing, taste, smell, touch, into that intuitive, prosperous manifestation that we all can be in the world. And that's what started it. You know, we were coming from a world of war, right, with the world war, into a vast time of materialism and industrialism. And it all began to shift when my siblings started, you know, the college education was easier to obtain in that point of time. And so we became free thinkers. I had the pleasure of being a free thinker in Unity, so that was really even different from most people. But, you know, that free thinking is, wait a minute, is this really what life is really about? And how do I play into this mass of confusion? What is mine to do? Who am I in all of this? And that's really, for me, what I believe that we were all seeking, and we began to seek outside of ourselves. Some chose to go into various religious orders. Some chose to go into communion living, which was different from our parents had ever done. And then some went into the world of drugs and addiction. And we made these choices because we were always seeking outside of ourselves. And through that, the realization is beginning to come now that the truth is not outside of us. Our truth is within us. And that brings us kind of into today. So we've still been in this process of moving from that Adam consciousness to the Christ consciousness to this day. And now we are beginning slowly to awaken, to realize the truth that in order for us all to live in peace, to let that love flow from inside of us outward, to awaken to that oneness that we all are, we're all interconnected. The whole world is interconnected. And the wars will not stop until all beings realize that we're all connected, till we all awaken. And that's scary, but it's already started. So that's some comfort. We know that it started because we're it. We are the changing factors. We get to be the love in the world. We get to do our own inner work and share it. I know many of you teach workshops and classes, and we do energy works, and you share your music, you share what you love, you share the expression of who you are on a daily basis, and that's what the world needs. The more we do that, one person at a time, it's the ripple effect, and the ocean and the waves begin to change the negativity in the world. It begins to allow people to awaken in other countries and other worlds and say, wait a minute, that's not the way I want to live anymore. And once the masses begin to awaken, then the turmoil that we see in the world will be stabilized and shut down. I have to believe that. I know it to be true. It's a learning for all of us. It's part of the world's awakening. We are part of that world's awakening. And it doesn't happen immediately. It's been going on for centuries. The 60s allowed us to turn on the light, that light which we call wisdom and unity. It gave us a different perspective, that we could be free. And we didn't know how, and because we didn't know how, we were in conflict. And that conflict is still playing out today. But what that light does is it gives us confidence. We know that there's a different way. And we're willing, as truth students, to step out into the world and say, there's a better way. There's a better way to have local governments, state governments, world governments. There's a better way to have social justice in our world. All of us, every being in this world, is a treasure. No matter who they are, no matter the walks of life that they've chosen, they are a treasure. All our brothers and sisters, everywhere we go, every person that's living on the street is connected to us. Every being on this planet is a part of us. And we get to choose what actions we're going to take as individuals and collectively as a community to make a difference. Consciousness is expanding. And if you're familiar with spiral dynamics, you know that as we move as a human race, we move upward. And as we move upward, we fall backwards. And that's where we're at. We'll move a little bit on the upward spiral, and we've been there for a while, and now we're falling backwards a little bit. And we'll move upwards in consciousness. It's all about our conscious thinking, the conscious choices that we make individually and collectively, as people, as families, as communities, as educators, as musicians, business professionals. The individual choices that we make affect everyone. And when we really, really, really decide that we want to be a positive effect in the world, then the change will happen. The vibration moves through us. That spark of life that is the Christ self within you is the vibration of life. We feel it when we're in meditation. We feel it when we're singing. We feel it when we're dancing. That vibration is that growing consciousness moving in and through us outward. And it's a blessing. It is truly, truly a new picture for all of us. The songs that Bill chose for today are both from the Mamas and the Papas. And it really touched my heart, my sister's favorite songs. And just to know that a piece of music can bring back a beautiful memory of a person who's no longer physically on this planet is amazing. She fought hard to make change in the world. From the time she was 16 all the way through college, she was on the buses and she was going down south, registering people to vote. She was walking in Washington. She was walking, if there was a protest going on, she was there. She was protesting the violence from Vietnam, because we lived through, as children, our dad's PTSD from World War II. And for all of us, the Vietnam War was something we didn't want anybody ever to go through, because we knew the impact that it had not only on the soldiers, and even today, the impact that war has on the individuals who are fighting and required to take another life is devastating. It's a terrible way for us to live, because it impacts that person's soul. It impacts that person's partner's soul, their children's souls. I know many of you probably served in various wars, whether it was World War II, the Korean War, the Vietnam War, Gulf Wars. We continue this mindset of fighting. And it's time to allow that darkness to be put to light. It's time to allow ourselves, individually and collectively, to be the love that we truly are. And I don't have all the answers. I'll be the first one to say, sometimes I don't know, I just throw up my hands and say, okay, here we go again. And I take a breath. But I do know that somehow, some way, the shift is moving faster. And we have a choice. We have lots of choices to make. We can live in that dark coldness of the negativity, or we can step into that presence of the creative power that each of us have to creatively and consciously be involved to change and be the change that we want in the world. In this room alone, the intelligence and the creative power to solve the world's problems right here. You guys got it. We just have to figure out how to bring it all together and harness it and begin the action steps to put it outward. Because if it's not us, who's going to do it? I know it seems like this huge, huge, huge undertaking. But it's so possible. I really, really believe that collectively we can do anything that we decide we really want to do. And begin to take the action steps to change and to create the change in the world. prayer is a wonderful tool. And we use it within ourselves to shift our own vibration. And this past Thursday, we did World Day of Prayer. We had two unity communities come together in the park. We had over 55 people there, probably 60, pretty close to it, because we ran out of candles. Yeah. And it was the courage to heal. So we were not only healing the two unity communities and creating unity in unity, but we were able to send blessings out into the world collectively with the people that were there and people from all over the world and other unity organizations doing prayer services collectively. Doing that more often, collaborating, creating prayerful vigilances, creating, manifesting our own individual works. I mean, this technology that we have today, we can go anywhere in the world and teach classes and talk to people around wherever we are, wherever they are. We can make connections worldwide. We need to do that. It's available. Some person probably figured out in their garage, we can do the same thing. As we continue this series, we know that the days of darkness, the skies that are gray, that the winter coldness is coming to an end. We get the warmth of summer and the summer of love. We know that we can come into the church and kneel and pray anytime, any day. We do a new meditation. Join me. Every day, except for Fridays. And if you want to be here on Friday, let me know. I'll be here too. Let's just join together and be who we really are. Love in the world. Summers bring the warmth, the light, the longer days to wash away the cold in the winter. The winters bring an opportunity for us to be still, to go within, to hibernate. And from that, we manifest and create from our hearts. And we do it with joy. We do it with love. And we do it with ease and grace. And we do it by dreaming. Dreaming one day at a time. With flowers in our hair. Bringing in the love and the light. Dream and dream big. Dream and see it unfolding and manifesting in your life. And in the lives of all those around you. It is possible. Anything is possible. There are no limitations. I love you. I bless you. I behold the living Christ in each of you. Namaste.
All the leaves are brown.
All the leaves are brown.
And the sky is gray. I passed a long way. Well, I got down on my knees,
down on my knees,
and I pretend to pray.
I pretend to pray.
You know the preacher likes the cold.
All right. Thank you all. That was beautiful. Yeah. What fun. We have such talent around here. See, that's what I'm talking about. We can solve all the world's problems right here. We got it. As we continue on in our service, it's time for us to do our prosperity proclamation. Now we're going to join together and take our blessings in our hands, and I don't know where mine got off to, but I'll just put my hands together. And if you're joining us online, you can go to our website, unityoflouisville.org, and make a donation. If you want to make a credit card donation from here, we will have people in the back after the service that will take and run your credit card for you. So just know we have options. And so now as we just take these gifts into our hand and enfold it and together, divine love through me blesses and multiplies all that I am, all that I have, all that I give, and all that I receive.
Mm-hmm.
And so now as we say our prosperity affirmation together, we are stewards of divine abundance. We give and receive with gratitude. And we see these blessings flowing in and through Unity of Louisville, blessing each of those who gave and who gives, blessing those who receive, blessing our community and the world. And so it is. Amen. We're going to watch a video showing the movie for next week. It's the movie trailer for Across the Universe. We will be having another potluck next week, and we're going to watch this movie together. Down at the bottom there, the other way. Yep. And then you can make it big.
Is there anybody going to listen to my story? All about the girl who came to stay.
As a stranger to our shores, the least I can do is offer you
some Ivy League hospitality.
This is Jude. This is my sister.
My God, you have perfect teeth.
Oh, I'm gonna try.
What are you gonna do if you don't go back to college?
What any irresponsible, unmotivated dropout would do, go to New York, like tonight.
All you need is love.
Is she a part of your ride?
God, I hope so.
All you need is love.
Come in. Just wanna get your eyes right.
That is all you need.
As blissful as you two are in the throes of young love, I got a date with Uncle Sam.
We're in the middle of a revolution, Jude, and what are you doing? Doodles and cartoons?
Oh, I'm sorry I'm not the man with the megaphone, but this is what I do.
Hey, Jude, don't make it bad. Take a sad song and make it better. Remember to let her into your heart.
Music's the only thing that makes sense anymore, man.
Stop.
Play loud enough. Keeps the demons at bay.
I just got to say that when I came to live in America in 2005 and got married to Lisa, I'd seen all this stuff of America in the 60s growing up, but it was just at such a distance, I didn't understand how the America and the psyche was changing. But after I saw that movie, I just got it. So if you get a chance to come and see that movie, it really talks you, shows you, you know, what America went through in the 60s. And on a scale of 1 to 10, it's got to be an 11. And they took about, I think it's about 24 Beatles songs and built a whole story around characters in the songs. And it's just fantastic. So we'll be showing that next week.
All right. And now from our board, Jackie's going to make an announcement about upcoming stuff.
Hi, friends. I'm Jackie Saltzman. I'm on the Board of Trustees here at Unity. And as Rev Ray mentioned in the newsletter last week, our fall book series is going to be on a book called Practicing Inclusivity. So to support that and also to support us as a community, the board has decided to offer a leadership training on diversity and inclusion. And it's for the board and the ministers and for some key community leaders or members who want to help us grow in that way. And right now we still have two spots available for the training to be on the team. So we are looking for two more community members who are interested in and committed to this kind of work. And we envision the commitment from the training and the team not just being learning the information, but actually putting it into practice in our individual lives and taking action and helping us make decisions as a church to grow in that way. Because we know that the commitment to this kind of work, to inclusivity, is imperative as a community no matter where we are physically. So if this sounds like fun to you or you're feeling called to this type of ministry, please come see me after church in the back of the sanctuary. And if you join the team, the commitment is not only the 8-hour training, which will be split up into 2 4-hour chunks. The first is September 30th, the end of this month, from 1 to 5, and then we'll schedule the other one after that. So it's the actual training, and then also to be on this growth team with the board and the ministers to help us make decisions and take actions in the community to help us grow in diversity, in numbers, and as a spiritual community. So if you have any questions, please see me after church. Thanks for your time. Namaste.
Lots going on around here. We are consciously making choices. All right, and now today, we'll take probably a 15-minute break and then come back up for the community meeting. And then after the community meeting is over and we voted and know the decision, then we will have our breaking bread and ta-da in the meditation garden, okay? So, lots going on. Just know that we are changing the world as we change ourselves. And now, here come our children. So, let's stand and sing in This Little Light of Mine.
I'm Dottie, and these are our children. Yay! Today we talked about Daniel in the lion's den and about jealousy and how come when we have those feelings of jealousy, then we can talk to God and those feelings help us feel better. So we also talked about our affirmation, which Lily is going to say, but I want to tell you all something before then. You all made our book sale a great success. We made over $700. Okay. And we got another donation from the Half Price Bookstore for $115. And then we got another donation in today for about $45 from a congregant. So that was a bunch of money, and we appreciate it. Your money that you helped provide for that book sale will go to help these kids go to their rallies and their Unitine retreats. So we have 4 going to a Unitine retreat later this month. So thank you very, very much for helping us out. And Lily's going to say our affirmation today. And this is Lily's first day, so she's really brave here.
God is everything I see.
I see God.
I see God.
In everything.
And everything I see.
There you go. Now you get to lead it and tell everybody else to say it with you. Everybody say it with us, okay?
Okay. I see God in everything I see.
And now for our prayer for protection. The light of God surrounds us. The love of God enfolds us. The power of God protects us. The presence of God watches over us. Wherever we are, God is, and all is well. Now for our peace song.
Namaste.